Okay, I see a Dutch mission. I should probably grab some stew if there's any stew. Where is the stew?
How's it going?
Oh, you know what I just thought about? I'm wondering if. Let's go donate some stuff. That map one that I can get, I'm wondering if that opens the entire map. Give items. Okay, this is gonna take a minute. Reverend is fucking wasted again. Contribute. Don't I still have? Yeah, it. I don't know why it backed out. Alright, now I need to contribute money. Let's do 300. I don't really know what else to spend my money on, so. Escalated quickly. Now that map. Purchase. I'll be nice. Let's contribute more. I really don't know what else to spend my money on, so. Give money. We'll do 240. Just to be able to buy that. Yep, so all that's left are these two. I've never actually bought anything for the camp before, so.
Arthur! Arthur!
What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
Well, not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
So, I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay. I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
Wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters who are coming for us, hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
I'm like that. Soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight.
So I didn't look at the map. Does it? So it didn't open the whole map. It didn't open any of the map. But I also didn't go look at it, so.
Some space between us and that mess now. Ain't seen no more Pinkertons for a while. There's these bounty hunters, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it. Reckon it's that one with the fire outside.
Let's take a look.
With all the broken windows and...
Shit, this don't look so good. Well, he clearly ain't here.
Someone got here first. By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Awesome.
Found anything?
There's some blood here. That ain't good.
What do you think?
Damn it, I can't activate
this
it while.
This food barely touched. Looks like he left in a hurry.
You see?
Anything else?
Thing there?
Bed's not made, so he must have been here recently.
Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd say. I guess maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet. Look. Tracks. Come on.
Okay, girl.
They went down the... Yeah. How's your tracking these days?
All right, I guess.
Well, lead the way then.
Not the kind of place I'd expect to see Trelawney staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in town.
You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean, after the bar fight, I swear, he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them that far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find him.
Yeah. I still ain't sure about that.
What are you getting off for?
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Have you seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
you seen him. Sort of formal?
Strange. Sure. formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
Yeah.
All right, you two.
Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here.
Come here!
Who do you think you are?
Who's talking now?
He'll be down a while.
Huh?
I think you punched him in the throat.
Where is Trelawney?
I don't know anything.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay, okay, for Christ's sake. They took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
That'll do it.
All right. That should do it.
Come on, let's go.
Follow me. I think there's a way around so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite's place.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, then.
You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least, I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses, and, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Yeah, kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal. He's got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
That's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent, keeping fish on the line.
That must be it.
Let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that shack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen.
That's a sawn off.
Is that the lot of them?
I think so.
So you're alive.
Allegedly.
Well, don't worry, they won't be for much longer.
Okay, go get them, Arthur. I can handle this.
Don't deal with them, my brothers!
Don't let them get away. Could have told them anything.
Trying to hide in the fields!
something this way. You wait till I find you. We got one more, Charles.
Did you see those birds?
He's dumped his gear. Look around. He can't have gone far.
Where, oh where? That's cute.
He's mine! Let me take him. You get out of here.
You have a sawn off.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Come on.
Come on.
He should have taken the money.
I know. I'm a fool.
Shit. Thank you.
Ow.
The gunshots are coming from that barn. Come on.
He's backing off inside! Get after him!
There he is! Take him out!
Good. He should be the last of them.
All right, let's go back for Trelawney. You all right?
Yeah.
This guy's had a lot of fucking money.
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery fella.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters to us? Mr. Trelawney, where are you?
Over here, dear boy.
Well, he's still here at least.
There we go.
Your feet up, why don't you?
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunters. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me, per se.
What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay. Bounty.
Everywhere we go, there's more and more civilization. Perhaps this is it from now on. We shall see, I guess.
I believe. Yep, we still have to go see John Marston. Yeah, I made over $100 off those fucking guys. Off those dead guys.
Like you boys had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Oh, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
Out by the stables, I think.
Thank you. And, sorry for your troubles, friend.
The puppy's whining. She probably already went to the bathroom. I'm only halfway where I want to get on this one. Here, I'll pause it here. Sorry about that.
Like you don't know me. You turn up in town, you're helping everybody. And there's troubles everywhere. Bandits attack my fields.
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
The hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
goddamn peasants. I don't know. Mongrels. Slave fuckers. All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
Where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
Go to the stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbred.
Coming past.
Yep.
Crazy old fool.
If he only knew we just torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about that.
Burning rich folks' property? Sean was like a pig in shit.
I'm sure. 5,000 for horses. They must be rich.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But if we get even a third of that, it'll be worth it.
So how are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions. Guard.
I'll speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
Our partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, okay, then. Look, head on up to the stables. Someone will come see you.
Hey!
That's it. Nice and easy. No need to rush. Don't want to draw any unnecessary attention. All right, I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down, play cool. Head around the front, hitch up there. Let's hitch up here. Let me do the talking. Hello there.
Can I help you, boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs, looking to do some breedings. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. If that's what you're interested in. What is your boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. Well, this here's... Uh-huh. Greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't... Nobody recognizes us.
All right. I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two.
Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Easy now.
Marston, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're going to lead the stallions. Hey, easy now.
It's okay, his neck is only broken.
Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, we regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Go, get out of here, I got
What the hell are you doing? Stop! Stop! We're being robbed! Stop these men! Stop! They're coming out of the field!
Watch it! There's guards by that wagon! What is happening? What am I, drag racing? Figured that would happen.
I'll get him. Got
you. Oh, come on. What the hell happened there?
Yep.
Did I catch it too early? Why does it keep getting away like that?
Come on. Gotcha. Come on now.
I was supposed to. Okay, I'm supposed to walk it back.
Hey.
I didn't know that. I thought I was supposed to calm it down and then, like, hitch it to my horse.
Come here! Hey, Morgan! Over here! You got him! Well done. Lemon's Cove's just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. You think think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
What you boys want?
Heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, Arthur, Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours, but I like you, and I'll give you, I'd give you 650 for
them. I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true, not one little bit.
But
I like you boys, but I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on. Yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
Believe the yarn spun us by one of that Gray family. Imagined we was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.
I wanna see. We'll see what that map actually does. Oh, it's a fast travel station. Okay.
I just broke my pocket mirror, and I remember me old ma saying that a broken mirror means 7 years bad luck.
7 years? We won't see 7 years out. Don't be ridiculous. But if I find a mirror on my adventures, I'll bring it back for you.
Thank you, Arthur.
Arthur!
Yes, kid.
You got a lot on?
What's that other marker? Nothing else, Lenny. I'd just rather go do this one.
He ain't perfect. But he's the closest I've met in this world.
Morning, Arthur.
You join us here, Morgan?
Are you busy, Arthur?
Why?
Well, I know you think I'm just some effete buffoon.
What?
A man of words and not of action. Hardly a man at all.
Well, I think you're as slippery as an eel in an oil slick, but still a man.
Because I think I've found something interesting.
Yeah?
Have you ever robbed a stagecoach?
No, never. Well, who would have even thought? Of course I robbed a goddamn stagecoach. You know I have.
And what's the problem with stagecoaches?
The armed man attempting to put a bullet in your head?
Not quite. The odds. I mean, is it worth the robbing?
Sometimes.
I know. But, well, if you'd like to come with me, I can introduce you to a new best friend, and he's going to give you all the decent, robbable stagecoaches a hot-blooded degenerate could require.
Well, I could require a whole lot. So where do we find this friend of yours?
Rhodes.
Because what can possibly go...
find out.
You sure seem to have got about around here.
You know me. I like to make friends in low places.
How the hell you end up down here anyway?
I could ask the same of you. I have a few commitments over this way. Some expenses to meet.
Expenses? What expenses? Gentlemen's canes and rabbits to pull out of hats?
Among other things. I had quite a nice little business going for a while. Shares in a gold mining company. Excellent returns for the investor of a certain financial standing. Until, well, that unfortunate run-in with the law.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Thanks for disappearing on us during that Sean business, by the way.
Here we are. We can hitch up outside. I'll make the introductions, Arthur.
Hello, Alden.
Hello, Josiah. How have you been?
Dandy. And you, friend?
Like I said, times are tough. My missus is a bad woman. Terrible woman.
They often are. But how's work, Alden?
Terrible. Wages got cut again. They reckon they just invented a new horse's carriage will be the end of us.
They've been saying that nonsense since they invented the wheel. The wickedness of bosses.
I know. My comrades here and I are greatly discouraged from the adequate fulfillment of our duty.
A discouraged man is no man at all, Alden. No man at all. My friend Arthur here has a present for you.
Ain't you kind, sir?
Call him Arthur. He's one of us, a fellow man of distinction.
Okay, well, this is perfect timing. I think you'll like this one, Josiah. It'll be coming south down the river road through Siltwater Strand.
Thank you, Alden. Thank you very much.
Oh, and Josiah, if you or Arthur are ever out Strawberry Way, ask for my colleague there. Feller called Hector. He's also one of the... What did you call us again?
Discouraged men, Alden.
That's it. Discouraged men. I like that.
Well, goodbye, Alden. Or should I say, adieu.
Oh, adieu, Josiah.
What the hell was that?
I thought you might like to see that pantomime.
River Road through Siltwater Strand, he said.
I thought after I got the tip it would be over. The puppy's whining. I gotta attend to her shortly.
Okay, let's go. This way.
Or just clean up her shit after. I'm sure she's gonna shit.
What did
if
I
she
tell
hasn't
you?
Already.
Simple as can be. Seems a lot of the station workers are in on it these days. Earning a pittance. The unions are whipping them up. So they want something on the side. Like he said, there, strawberry. Could create a lot of opportunities for a man in your line of work.
I ain't sure about going back to strawberry after all that mocking business.
Didn't sound like you left anyone alive to recognize you, so I wouldn't worry too much, dear boy. All this trouble, you gentlemen are becoming quite the celebrities, aren't you? Soon you'll be on the front of a dime novel. And dead, of course.
We're hoping to be long gone before that. Dutch has a plan.
Ha! Here we are. This is the spot. Okay. This should do.
Sure. Here.
I'm hoping we won't need those.
Better safe than sorry. So what were you thinking?
Well, according to this, the loot is located in a strong box, which is in the back. I'll put on a little performance, and you can scurry around, open the strong box, and relieve them of their goodies.
And how do I open the strong box without threatening someone to open it for me?
This should work.
And I can do this silently?
Well, I'm hoping complete silence won't be necessary. But you're going to wish you had your earplugs. This is Damson. Oh, very good, Alden. Very good. Of course, if everything goes wrong, you can wave your guns around like you normally do. Hold tight. They'll be here soon. There it is. Right on time. Let's go. Keep your distance so they don't see you. And please leave that gun in its holster for once. Ahead and get the coach to stop. You hang back. Don't let them spot you or you'll scupper the whole thing.
Hold up.
I hope you don't mind my singing.
Not at all.
I'm the best.
It's a free country.
If that guy doesn't move, I won't be able to do this.
Miss Damson, you owe it to West Elizabeth.
You three don't lash it or don't lash our Verdi.
My goodness, she is noisy.
Well done, sir. Well done.
It was easy. You did all the work.
Teamwork, my dear boy. Teamwork.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Okay. You get $3.
Go see Alden from time to time. See you soon, Arthur.
Holy shit. It's a lot of money for him to sing. Alright, hope you enjoyed.